जय श्री कृष्ण फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आज की तेज एस्ट्रोलॉजी। कृष्ण इज हैप्पीनेस, कृष्ण ही खुशी है जो ऑलवेज है। एंड टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट द कंजंक्शन ऑफ मार्स एंड सैटर्न इन योर चार्ट। एंड आई मेड अर्लियर वीडियो व्हेन जुपिटर एंड राहु आर सिटिंग टुगेदर इन एनीबडीज चार्ट और व्हेन जुपिटर और केतु इज सिटिंग इन एनीबडीज चार्ट। प्लीज वॉच दोज वीडियोज ऑल्सो। आई विल बी प्रोवाइडिंग द लिंक इन दिस वीडियो इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बिलो। And then before starting the video, please subscribe the channel, like it, comment it, keep supporting as you are doing. And I'm very much obliged for that. And please push the notification bell also, so you would get all my videos that I post time to time. And then if you want to take consultations from me, if you have any queries, if you want me to do your birth chart analysis, it's very easy to contact me. My numbers keep flashing in the video and it's always given in the description below of the video. So it's very easy to call me, contact me, WhatsApp me. So friend, we'll start with the Mars and Saturn's conjunction when it is sitting in anybody's chart. Actually, it's a very beautiful combination, conjunction, and at the same time, it's the most dreadful one also. See, both of the planets, they hold different kind of energies. And the person who are knowing it and the person who are not knowing it, for them also I'll tell. Like, see, I see always see planets in a very different aspect, different angle, as I always say. I don't see planets like if they are malefic ones or they are good ones or they are benefic ones for anyone. See, every planet for me is a benefic planet. Till that time, we don't understand what the planet is saying us to do. See, all the incarnations of Lord Vishnu or Narayana, they represent all kind of planets in Vedic astrology also. So for Mars, it is Narsingh Narayan, and for Saturn, it is Kurma Avatar. So see, both the planets, they represent some form of Vishnu. So you can't say that Mars is a bad planet or a malefic planet or Saturn is a malefic planet. See, because both of them, they are incarnation of Lord Vishnu only, and they hold certain kind of energy. Lord Narsingh Narayan, Narsingh Avatar, was for something else. It was an aggressive incarnation of Lord Vishnu. And then at the same time, Kurma Narayan was a slow and steady avatara, and that is for that was for something else. That was when Samudra Manthan was going on, and that churning of the ocean was going on, the mountain was going on. And then Lord Vishnu, it took the avatar of Kurma Avatara so that that mountain can be placed on the back of the tortoise, that Kurma, and so that can be easily churned. Otherwise, the mountain was going inside the ground, like in the ocean. So Kurma Avatar is also very important. It tells us to be studied, to be very disciplined, to be very structured. So in both the ways, now you can understand, like Narsingh Avatar also, it was for benefit, it was a beneficial avatara to save someone, to save Prahlad from Hiranyakashipu, the demon. And then Kurma Avatar was also for the beneficial of the devatas. So both the avatars, now you know that they are for the benefit of everyone. So Mars and Saturn, they both are a benefit for every soul on this earth. But we have to understand the energy, what they are telling us to do. See, Mars represents in everybody's chart, it represents all kind of energy, aggressiveness. It represents all kind of fast work, fire. It represents all kind of impulsive action. It represents all kind of confidence, blood, any kind of like soldier, military, warrior, athletic, brother, all kind of impulsive action, instant action. And at the same time, Saturn represents slowness, steadiness, poverty, some kind of like law and order, discipline, oldness, like traditional things, conservative things. It represents oil at the same time. On the other hand, Mars represents fire at the same level. Then some of the unknown fears are also attached to Saturn. That slowness is also attached. Some kind of teachings are also attached. Some kind of karmic connection is also attached to Saturn. Now, when these two planets come together, what happens to the person generally, like in anybody's horoscope, if these two planets are sitting together? See, It is just like you can imagine that you are driving a car with the brakes on. So now you can understand this is the position of a native who is having this planetary conjunction in their chart. Now you can understand this very easily. See, you want to proceed also, and then there are breaks also. You want to start also something new, and then you are always like thinking about whether to start, whether you are going to succeed or you are going to fail. Or sometimes you will do certain kind of action and then you will repent afterwards. Or you will not start a action only because you will be thinking over it. Like you will be like wasting time in that thinking. So what will happen? Sometimes you will start some kind of action too early and that will result in failures. And then at some time you will never start any action and then it will create depressions. So it is a constant frustration that is going on in your mind, like restrained impulsiveness. Like you have to restrain also, and that impulsiveness is also there. You have to do certain things also, and then something is holding you back also. In the childhood ages, like when we are growing up, these things are like more seen. The effect of this Mars and Saturn is more seen, because see, on the other hand, on the outer world, when we'll see, like when we are kids, and if somebody is having this Mars and Saturn combination in their chart, so in the early days, like father is also telling us to do the same thing, what Mars and Saturn, like they are behaving in your chart. He's also behaving the same way because he's telling us to do certain things. He's telling us, our father is telling us not to do certain things. Then in school also, like we are being told, like you have to do this, you don't have to do this. So again, that conflict is going like in like on the outward front also and the inward also, like Mars and Saturn, if they are sitting in anybody's chart. So there is like continuous conflict going on between like in the outer world also and the inner world also. So like in the starting years, it's a very difficult combination if you will think, because if you will not know the energy, what it wants to tell to you, what it wants to indicate to you, you are not going to accept that energy very nicely. And what happens is person grows into frustration. So many like anger things come, mad rush come, you are into fights and more negative energy, like the more darker side of it. If it is sitting into some bad houses or bad signs, then there can be problems related to like fighting or cheating or frauds, or you can go into like depressions, or you'll have a bad name, poverty will come, you'll be out of money, there'll be fights with the in your like marital life also. See, I've made video on Mars, like on the Mangalik position, and see now example, if Mars is sitting in the seventh house and it is a Mangalik position, it is a tough position. Now if Saturn is also sitting there, now you can understand this energy is going to create more problems for the in the married life. So you have to be very disciplined, very structured into that. And then there can be problems related with your servants, then there can be problem related with your brothers also, because Mars represents brothers and at the same time Saturn represents servants. So if it is playing on the wrong side, this energy, if this energy is going on to the negative side, then there are going to be problems related to all these areas, like professions also. You will not do very good at professions also, because all the time you will be wanting to start something new, and then you will do in some kind of mad rush, mad action you will take because of Mars. It is always action. It does not think much. It does not give it a second thought also to anything, and they just rush into things. And then at the like, and eventually what happens is you end up in failures. Then again you will start, then now you will be hesitant in starting something because of Saturn. Now when Mars and Saturn are sitting together, now you will be doubting your own abilities. Now you will be thinking like whether you are fit to do any kind of job or not, whether you are going to start this work or not, you can do this work or you can't do this work. You will be doubting your ability, you will be very strict on yourself, and that can cause many health problems also when Mars and Saturn, they are sitting together. Because see, continuously this pendulum is like moving, like that clock pendulum is moving in your life, like it is vacillating here and there. You, the other point, the other moment you are thinking that you should go for it, and the other moment it is like you shouldn't go for it. So you are stuck in between these kind of thoughts always when Mars and Saturn, they are sitting together, and it can create lot of frustration, it can create lot of delays, or it can create instant action that will create more problems than your energy. While speaking also, it can go berserk, you can hurt people, you can damage people by your speech only. See, it depends on the houses also where this Mars and Saturn combination is sitting. Because see, one point I have told you, like no energy is bad for me. Saturn and Mars is also a beautiful energy. Now see, what will happen is Mars and Saturn, when if they are sitting together, we'll talk about the positive side also now. Like see, this energy will give you a lot of courage. This energy, when it is there, the people with this energy, Mars and Saturn combination, they are not going to give up like in on anything. Like they are going to fight, that is for sure. That they are not going to lose the battles in life. They are very courageous, they are very structured, they are very disciplined, they are very goal oriented. They want achievement, they want success, they want everything in their life, and they are like that. They are good advisors also. Like you can now, you can think, how can they be good advisors? See, these people, they know what is a starting point, what is the ending point. Because see, Mars is starting, Saturn is the ending point. So they know both the ends. Now they have to structure themselves, they have to discipline themselves, and they have to work according to it. It should not be like that they should know when to start and they shouldn't know when to stop, or they are already stopped and they are not doing anything. So in this continuous battle, they will be learning lot of things in their life. So they will be great advisors. They can give advice to people that can be very oriented, very pointed, and their suggestions and their advice will not falter. Because see, they have gone through lot in their life. They have gone through lots of ups and downs. They have seen many ups and downs in their life. They know about all the pros and cons of the situation. They know how to deal with the situation, because they themselves have fallen in that. They themselves have faltered in that. Now they know the correct answers for it. Now whenever they will do something, whenever they will give advice to someone, that will be the golden advice. They have tested that. That they have gone through that problems. Now they have mastered that problem. And now they, if you will ask them, see, if they have opened a medicine shop, these fellows, like if they have opened any kind of pharmacy, and now they have failed also in that. Now, but if they will tell you, and you are going to open a pharmacy or any kind of medicine shop, now it is 100% accurate that you are never going to falter. You are going to run a good business, because they are going to tell you all the minus and plus point what they have gone through. Because of their experience, they are going to tell you. So they are great advisors. They are great problem solvers. They are great in mechanical and technical line. They are very practical. They are very grounded. Like when Mars and Saturn, they are sitting together, and when this positive energy is playing in their life now, they are grounded. They know, like these are the people who will not build like castles in the air. They know what is the reality of life. They know what are problems. They know how to face with it. They are the problem solvers, because they have got hundreds of problems in their life themselves, and they have solved it. So they are great problem solvers for everyone else also, and for themselves also. They are great in technical and mechanical field, like engineering field. They can be the best civil engineers or mechanical engineers. So they are the people who know how to make a fast car, like at that runs on 500 kilometers per hour, that kind of speed car they know how to make, and then they know how to control it also. So the journey between making a car and how to control it nicely is Mars and Saturn's good combination. And the other aspect of it is they know how to make a car and then they are going to meet with an accident because they don't know how to stop and how to control it. So Mars and Saturn, you can understand that is beginning and start. They know how to make anything. They are the people who are going to make the like nicest and the safest of bridges if they are going to make, because they know they are very fast also. They'll finish the work in no time also, and then they'll be no. That bridge is going to be very strong also. It's going to be from all the aspects, if you will measure that bridge, it is going to be accurate, it is going to be perfect. They are the persons who are best suited for these kind of jobs. They are going to do good in like political fields also, trade unions also. They are going to be great surgeons. They are going to be great people who are into law, into any kind of military, police, doctors. These kind of things they can do very easily, because all these, like these are the areas, like the more aggressive types, the more problems are there in these areas, and these people are fit to do their work in these kind of areas, like engineering also. It is a very hard kind of job, surgeons or in the law or the police field or the defense department. They are fit to be there because they are courageous. They know how to deal things. Then they are disciplined also. They are structured also. They have to be structured. Otherwise, they are going to waste their life. The other important point for them is now, when Mars and Saturn both are sitting together, what you have to do? You have to be much structured. You have to be much disciplined. You have to be like thinking like 10 times. You have to think like what you have to do in life. Otherwise, there can be problems. Like if you are going to start something, you are going to face problems. Or if you are never going to start anything, then again there is going to be problem. You have to obtain like much of self-control in yourself, self-discipline. And then you expect also this from others also. But that is wrong again, because that is going to create problems with others. Because see, this Mars and Saturn energy is playing in your chart. It's not playing in anybody's other's chart. They are not facing those kind of problems like you are facing. So you have to deal with that. You can't put your things on someone else. If you are disciplined, if you are structured, if you are concentrated, if you are focused, you have gone through a lot. Now you have achieved that kind of thing, like how to work, when to work, what kind of work you should do. You shouldn't expect that other people also, they are going to behave in that manner. Otherwise, you are going to face in like lot of problems in relationship, at work front also. There are a lot of problems with you in those fronts also. You are going to expect those things from others. These other people, you can say, they are more structured ones, most organized one, more practical one, because they have gone so much through in their life, like that now they have understand what is success, what are the losses, when to start, when to stop, when to work in between, what kind of work is needed. Like if Saturn gives that kind of slow and steadiness also, the old school of thought it gives to Mars, and then Mars will never falter when it is moving as a warrior. He'll just not jump into things. Saturn wants it to cool down also, to be restricted also, to move at the right time also. They shouldn't move at once, and then they shouldn't spoil the thing, or they shouldn't take much long time also, like because of Saturn. This also, this energy tells, it's always not that you have to think like about 100 times about a thing and the time will go. Sometimes these people will start too late, or they will start too early to finish a thing, and then again there'll be a lot of problems, depressions and things in their life. So Mars and Saturn energy is very beautiful. It is just, you know, it is just that kind of energy where you know everything, where you know all the positive results also, where you know all the success is also there, and then you know from where the problems can come, from where the frustrations can come. And if see this negative energy, if you are going to go into the negative side of Mars and Saturn, then I have told you this energy is just like it is just an atomic bomb. It can explode in your life, and there will be a whole lot of problems regarding relationships, regarding anything. See, for example, you see, if it is sitting in the second house, see Mars and Saturn, if they are sitting in second house, that means you can be, and if it is playing a negative role in your chart, if you are not understanding that energy, you are going to speak with everyone with a very like harsh tone. You are going to kill them, the other person, by your speech. For money also, you are just going to hoard the money and like you are going to just snatch it or like take control of it. Like money always will be there, or my fights will be there in the family also because of money. You are not going to see about the family where they are going. You just want money in your life. You just want status, symbol, all that kind of things in your life. And in that way, you can just destroy your relationship. You can just destroy your speech, your and everything. Now, if Mars and Saturn are sitting in anybody's like anybody's horoscope in the second house, if you want to take positive energy from Mars and Saturn, what they are telling now, they are telling you to first think, then you should speak. You should always speak nice to everyone. You should always speak to give advice to everyone. You should always hold everyone intact, like in your family and everything. You should use your money to help your family. Mars and Saturn, they are telling you this. These people are most of the time they are pessimist. You have to be optimist also on the second hand. Like they are going to always think about the negative sides of the things and their problems and the fears and the depressions and the falls and the failures. So you have to shift your mind towards the sun, towards the light of the sun always, to get the actual energy what is there in Mars and Saturn. You have to behave in a more nicer way, or on a more practical way, the grounded way, the concentrated way, that the energy that is giving Mars and Saturn's energy is telling you to be more organized, more successful, like oriented. And where that success is going to come by, when you are going to take yourself very seriously, in a very disciplined approach, in a very practical approach, very concentrated you will be, and then all kind of success is going to come to you. You will be the person who are going to make you yourself successful, and then you are going to make the organization where you are working that also successful, and the people who will come into your touch, they will also be successful because you are that kind of energy. You know what are failures, you know what is success. You are the person who know when to start. You are the person who know when to stop. You are the person who know what goes in between success and failures. So you know very well what is going around there in the world. Now you should understand whether you want to use that racing car and win races in a controlled way, or you want to make a car and then go and meet with an accident, and then everything is Sitaram. So now you have to decide when Mars and Saturn are sitting together. So always you have to see the energy, what kind of things like Mars and Saturn they are giving you, what they are expecting from you. See, now for example, if this Mars and Saturn they are sitting in sixth house, it is very easy for you to go into any kind of like problems, fight, diseases, and any kind of lock, like cases can come upon you, and there can be a whole lot of problems. You can unnecessarily take up loans for anything, and you will not end up the projects, and there will be a whole lot of problems on you. And then on the other hand, you can fight yourself for the good of the other people. Like you can be a lawyer, you can be into surgeon. You can go for surgeon, you can go for military, you can go for defense, police department, all these things. Or you can be a leader in any kind of union, you can be enter into politics, and you can serve people for that, you can help people into that. So the sixth house is the problematic house, and when Saturn and Mars are sitting together, that means double problems are going to come to you, and easy problems are going to come to you. Like you are just going to pick up the fight like that, like it is like that. So it is better to understand that energy, and then it is very advisable to divert that energy into a nice way. Like please divert, like, well, Saturn and Mars, they are sitting in the sixth house. It is, if other things are also going correct in your chart, in your horoscope, then it is good that you choose any field that relates to any kind of service to other people, like to remove their sorrows, to remove their sickness. It is of no use to increase your sorrow instead. So you have to understand the energy where it is going. It is going to give you all kind of success, money, recognition. It just wants you to make more approachable. It wants you to be more nicer, like more nicer than anybody else also, because I have told you, you are now holding this power, you are having this power, you are the person who really believes in karma mostly, you are not the dharmic type, you are not the spiritual type. On the other hand, you should be a little spiritual also. You should always be on the side of dharma, and then you should always go for any kind of physical exercises also, like always, just to take out this energy. If you are into any kind of job, whatever you are doing, and still these Mars and Saturn energy is going into your mind, you have to still take out that negative energy in some form or the other. And best is exercise. You should go for exercise, anything like cycling, swimming, or walking, brisk walking, jogging, anything you should take. You should take any kind of exercise in your life, because this energy wants to escape from something. So it is better to use it into exercise, or you are going to have lots of problems, like hypertension will be there, that bipolar tendencies will be there. Like people are going to say, like, we can't understand these kind of people in whose like chart Mars and Saturn will be sitting together. It will be very difficult for other people to understand you, because one moment you will be saying something and the other moment you are going to go back from what you said. So it is very difficult for other people to understand you also, to keep relationships with you also. And then accidents are always there, bruises, cut and fire things are always there. You have to be very cautious into that. And Mars and Saturn, they are telling you to live a more structured, more disciplined, more nicer life. You have to be like that to get all the positive results of Mars and Saturn together when they are sitting in your life, in your chart. So Mars and Saturn, they are beautiful energies. You have to understand that they are not there to trouble you. They just want to teach you some kind of lessons in life, that nobody else is ready to take that kind of lessons now in your life. Maybe God has put Mars or Saturn in your life to make you more tougher, more nicer, more practical, more grounded, more concentrated, more like it is giving you more ability. See, God, like when it sends everybody to this planet Earth, then if Mars and Saturn are sitting together in your chart, so for you actually it is a lottery. Because see, you know, I have told you earlier in this video, like, you are the person who know what is success, what is energy, what is fastness, what is impulsiveness, and like in a right way. And then you know, you are the person who knows what kind of, like, what is problems, what are the questions, what are the slow points, what are the depressions, what are the endings. You know everything now. In between also, you know how to tackle those problems also. So with you, it is actually a lottery for you when Mars and Saturn are sitting together, because you are the person who is the right judge to be on the position. Like you are the person to judge right, like everything. You are the person who is knowing to do what kind of work, like any kind of work. You are in a more better position than anybody else. Like if in their chart Mars and Saturn are not sitting together, maybe they are not having that kind of energy. Maybe they know how to start or they don't know how to end. Maybe they are very quick and then they don't know how to be steady in life. They don't know both the things in their life. For you, it is an opportunity. So take it in a nice way and see if you are going to not understand this energy. Then these are the two natural malefic planets. When they will come together, I have earlier told you, 100 problems, 1000 problems are going to come to your life regarding all the aspects, like wherever they are sitting in your house, wherever they are expecting, they are going to make your life like a hell. They will just spread poison everywhere because of, like, you not understanding their energy, because their energy is very nice. They want to tell you to be structured, to be disciplined, to do good to yourself and to be good to others also, to advise others, to help others, because of your energy, because of your courage, because of your stamina, because of your direct approach also and steady approach also. So you are the person who is controlled of this, any situation, like any given situation. I have told you, you are the person when Mars and Saturn are sitting together, you are never going to give up a fight. You are going to fight till the end, no matter whatever happens. Maybe you will stop, then again you will come back. So Mars and Saturn are like this. So you have to understand the energy. Its energy is beautiful. Both are, like I have told you, both represent incarnation of Lord Vishnu. Please accept and take their beautiful energy and be very self-disciplined, structured, understand what they are saying to you according to the houses they are sitting in your horoscope, and then work according to that. You are best suited. Never doubt your ability. You just have to understand that you can't just start things, any things, before thinking about its consequences. So Saturn is there to make you understand that also. Mars is there to make you do things also. So it does not mean that one time you just do any kind of action and don't think about it, or you always are in the thinking mode and you are not doing any kind of action. So please come out of that. You have to do action also, and that too in a nice way, in a approached way, in a structured way. That is only the motive of this conjunction in your planet. If you will understand this, nobody is going to be better than this conjunction, like in anybody near, because you will be the people who will be assessing things in every aspect. You will be knowing things about everything, and then you will be the person who will be advising also other. You will be the person who will be helping also. Like, you will be the person who will be much structured, much disciplined. You will be very orderly. You will be knowing every in and out of the things, all the problems and the answers, solution. You will be the good advisors. So please recognize your energy. You are beautiful. Mars and Saturn, when they come together, they create wonders, and don't make it a curse in your chart. They are wonderful. Just respect their energy and work according to that. And as the age will mature, it is going to help you more, because in the early ages is going to give you some tough questions in your life, some tough times in your life, and then it will make you understand what the real life is as Mars and Saturn. Or if you are watching this video now, you will be understanding this. And if you are in your young age or still you are a kid, it's going to help you very much. And I'll see you in my next video. I hope you will like this video. Jai Shri Krishna.